I just realized I don't have my chat window. There we go, that's better. What up, Prasad? Hate mosquito bites. Hello, brother. Love from India. Love from Raleigh, North Carolina, man. Hope you're having a good day. Okay. I want to go set up PMPM workspaces. PMPM workspaces. It's so bright. All right, show me how to get started. Wonder if I can just use Turbo. Yeah, this is probably what we want. Right, so let's see if we can get this to work. I want to start sharing some of my code across these packages. Yeah, yep, exactly. I was copying and pasting a lot of types in code. So we're going to try to get this turned into a monorepo. What we had yesterday, we added metrics, DB table migration. I've never actually, that's a lie. A couple years ago, I set up a monorepo from scratch. But it was with NX. All right, let's see if we can do this. So theoretically, if we go to our root, which is going to be here, what do we have? Oh, there's something else I wanted to do. I wanted to try using exa instead of ls. We'll come back to that after we get this set up. Well, we're about the dog food turbo repo, so we can either make changes ourselves or let the team know. So let's do bunx create turbo. Really, we should be able to do create turbo at latest. Maybe we do need the dash. Off to a glowing start. I typoed it. skill issued myself. I was about to message Shu and be like, dog. Oh yeah, we're going beta, baby. Oh my lord, fine. We'll go up and we'll do Whoops. I love coffee, chat. I love coffee so much. Does anyone use Ezza? Come on, Nyx. All right, what's the next step? There we go. We'll do that in a minute. So if we then go back up here and we'll do project bucket list. Fun. Great. All right, let's get acquainted with our, let's see here. How's this set up? So we have Turbo, great. Well, we definitely don't need that. So we don't build anything. How did we just get the gleam? Okay, that looks fine. Packages, let's just look at that. Base.json, sure. Package.json. Is there anything special beyond that top level? So that's exactly what we want right here. Okay, so let's, we really just need to take some of the stuff in this package.json and move it over to our other repo. So let's do a vertical split and go up, up, up. Over here, and in here, why is DS store in there? We can really copy these two over to here, right? And let's grab what's in the git ignore over here. Mm-hmm, We can get rid of these. Grab build outputs, throw them over here. We don't use those. Yeah, we can grab, we already have DS store. Okay, cool, 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 cool. Okay, we're getting there. And now, what is this? We can move that into a package too. Good morning, JD. All right, so let's just have this up and ready to go. So let's reorganize our repo. I guess this doesn't need to be Vim, huh? And I know. It's frustrating. Actually, what we're gonna do here is quit out of this, go up one. We're gonna move project bucket list to turbo example. Turbo example. And then we're gonna move underscore project bucket list to project bucket list. Nice, that's awesome. It's a sick tattoo. Turbo example, and then if we come over here, let's Vim back in here. Now we have our, that's not what we want. I messed up my file system, project bucket list. Here we go. Build depends on input turbo output lint dev cache persistent. All right, I don't know how any of this stuff works, but let's go in here and let's start doing this. We want apps. I guess that's up. We'll have apps do that, and then packages. How did we do that over here? Under packages, we have, let's just say we look at the UI. Yeah, we can get rid of lint. All right, so we have generators, that's kind of cool. I might go grab a hoodie instead of this flannel. All right. So our apps are gonna be, we can basically rename packages. And that's packages.
Jesus.
All right, so under apps, we should have that, great. And let's go into our package JSON here and split. And then I wanna look at, I guess we don't need to really split. Turbo, apps, web. How, do they do anything special in here? They just point at dependencies. Okay, that should be okay. So then let's start setting up our packages, because I really want like a, for sure, a package for Drizzle. In fact, we can just make this like form or gated, I don't even know what to call this. We'll call it Drizzle for now. And we'll come in here and we'll button it. I guess we don't really want to call that Drizzle though, because that's gonna have a name conflict. What do we want to call that package? Just DB, I guess. Yeah, DB will be fine. Okay, so let's then go up, change directory into DB, and we'll do bun. Why don't I have that? Nix shell, nix packages, bun. And we'll do bun init. Morning, Vafi. Great.
Functions describe the world.
All right. So this is a good start. So let's grab this and we're going to move it up into packages, into DB, and drop that in there. Yep. And then we want, what else do we want here? We want to grab, oops, wrong way. Apps front. Basically all of these scripts. I'll go into there, I'll go in here, save that, back up, apps, front, and then we want to grab routes, not routes, lib, server, drizzle. Oh, we'll want to do superbase too. Just finished the gym, how about you? I didn't get as much sleep as I wanted, as normal, but we're rocking and rolling. I got the first, I don't know, 10 to 15 slides of my OCaml or React with OCaml conference talk for Spain ready last night, well, during the debate. So we're making progress there. I just realized the song cue is borked. Do I have something in my buffer right now? Yeah, okay. Lib. Server. Yeah. packages, DB, source. There we go. And what else do we need from there? We probably need drizzle config, huh? Let's take both of these and put those in the root of this. And finally, let's go clean up front. Well, let's not clean up front. Let's get this package working first. So let's actually, what do we want to do here? We need to add, let's open our package JSON, and this is that. We can yoink these, move these over here. That'll be under scripts. Do that. And then we want to grab, I'm going to line all these up that I want to grab. Prettier, Svelte, Tailwind, TS. What were we using TSLib for? I have no idea. Hey Siri. Pause the HomePod.
I stopped the living room.
One second, chat. I gotta do something for work. All right, hold on, chat. There is an incident and somebody is asking for a review on a PR. Oh, somebody just got to it. Okay, cool. Has anyone ever worked on a billing and payments team or a money team? I did for like, I don't know, four years-ish, 3.5, 4 years. And it is always a fire, no matter how high the quality of your software is. Billing and payment systems and teams are always just a perpetual dumpster fire. It's so stressful. I do not envy people who work on those teams, but I have the deepest respect for them because I've been there. All right, we want that. Let's go ahead and do this. Replace that with 6.2. Yoink. And we're just gonna drop TypeScript in there, get rid of this. And we'll probably add sync pack to make sure that I don't think we need our prelude for that. We need you. We need probably you lid. Dependencies. Did I spell that right? Yeah, I think I did. Oh yeah. Yep. 100%. It's not a fun job at all. All right, let's go ahead and run bun install. All right, we got all those. And let's see if we have... I thought so. Let's quit that and we'll do that again over here. Right. We're gonna do a, let's quit Vim, so the project root. Let's see here. We're gonna change into packages, drizzle, that way, or DB, that way we're scoped better. Vim in here, and we wanted to touch foo.ts. We're gonna type check from here. Yep. And we're gonna wanna change the path for this to be, that should be just under drizzle. We don't need the Lucia adapter. Okay, let me get out of this. I was put there to build character. I'll tell you what, it will build your character. So if we go to Spectre is an amazing find and replace tool, global project find and replace tool for NeoVim. Highly recommend if you guys are on that. So if we see lib/server, we want to replace that with nothing, basically. It's oh, you son of a bitch. //. That probably needs to be escaped. Oh wait. Spectre, go back in. We want to search for //. We want to replace that with /. And this doesn't actually need to be up source. Yeah, if you look on the GitHub, people talk about that. I have like a find and replace to nuke those like -r files. I don't know why it does that. So we need to install Oslo Crypto too. So let's do over to the. Bun install Oslo. Is that the right package? Front. Yeah, okay, so we just need to do that. Great. Cool. And then in here, I guess we can go back to that foo file and close this out over here, close that, make this full screen, run type checking again, and we're just gonna go manually. There's only so many. What directory are we in? Drizzle/db. Yeah, that's the path we want. Maybe I was wrong to delete source. And this is, okay, yeah, I get it. This will not belong in here. So we can get rid of this one. Actually, no, we don't want to do that. All right, actually, maybe these scripts do belong in the seed stuff. Yeah, they probably do belong in front. That's fine. All right, this does not need to be in here either. And now let's, yeah, that looks good. We can get rid of this index. All right, let's change this to dot drizzle and go up here. We'll make that a dot drizzle and make sure there's not anything stupid in the drizzle config that refers to its own directory. All right, I think we should be getting close here. All right, let me catch up on chat too. I haven't been paying attention at all. I have a weird issue with spec. Oh yeah, we talked about that. I've been working on a backend that should handle concurrent requests elegantly. What are the best ways to implement that in a Node project? Sora, I mean, if you're using any normal HTTP server, you can handle requests concurrently as long as they are non-blocking, and not like, or yeah, as long as they're non-blocking, that meaning like as long as you're not doing long computations and blocking the event loop. The other thing you could do is use the cluster module. If you're deploying to a single CPU core machine, this isn't really applicable, but if you're on a machine with multiple CPU cores, you can use Node or Buns worker module, or not worker module, cluster module, and basically scale your app across all your CPU cores, and then requests will come in round robin. So you can do that. Hey bro, what did you think of the Laravel stuff? What do you mean in particular about the Laravel stuff? Svelte thoughts, how's the transition from React? I like Svelte a lot. I think it makes the hard parts of React simple. I like that the boundaries between client and server are really explicit and clear. I definitely do miss parts of React, but like Svelte 5 feels a lot like React, so it's not that foreign, but I definitely like the simplicity. I'm using the Svelte 5 RC, so like I've hit some like gotchas here and there. The language server is kind of annoying because it requires prettier, and I would rather be using Biome to lint my projects, so that's kind of annoying. from Theo's stream the other day. I don't want to comment too much on it other than I think Theo has a tendency to get too frustrated too quickly and make sometimes rash opinions on things too quickly that ends up spurring drama that doesn't need to happen. But I don't know. I think the Laravel team took it in stride and they handled it like a good open source team would. So kudos to the Laravel folks. Let's see here. Where are we at? Are we type checked? We're type checked. Excellent. Now I want to see if we can get this project into if we can get this package into our app. So let's come in here and it's gonna be that. How did they do this in Turbo? So that's web. Is this under packages? Let's go. I'm gonna look at this. This is gonna be repo. Okay. And in here, do we name all the packages? No, we don't. Where do we make inventory of our workspaces? How does it know to reference them by at repo? Like, how does it know to do this? Where's that set up? Is that in? Did I accidentally delete a file? Any thoughts about shadcn ish CLI, but for config slash React hooks? Do you think web dev needs it? There's like a hooks website that you could tap into pretty quickly. I don't know. I have a tendency to just like, I try not to install dependencies like that. Well, actually, now that you say that, shadcn, hold on. Let me back up. You have a great idea. You're solving the exact problem I was about to bitch about. I think that would be great. Because like, there's like this React hooks. Website, I don't know what it's called. Use hooks. If you tapped into use hooks and made a shad CN like thing where it just dumped this into your project instead of installing whatever it's called, an NPM package, that would be a good idea. If you build that, let me know and I will share it all over Twitter. Because I think that's a great idea. All right, how the hell did it use the aliases? I should have just freaking. Hold on. Now I'm fracking confused, chat. Yeah, okay, I get it. I get it. You're confused. I deleted the directory you're in. It's gonna be okay. I feel like I just skilled issue myself here because I copied and replaced a bunch of files without reading the docs. I should have just read the docs. All right. So let's make sure we have that in our root package JSON, which is going to be here. We have that. I still don't understand where. Where the namespace is coming from. The name field. What is the name field? We use at repo or docs. This is unused, uncleanable. You can use to keep it. What up, Purplish? Okay, now I am confused, disgruntled dev. I don't actually. How does it know? I feel like I'm going crazy. How does it know to resolve at repo? How does it know? I don't understand how it knows that. I'm going crazy. Oil.mvim berserk. Somebody please explain this to me because I am puzzled. I feel like I'm going crazy. There's nothing. Can I just change that? Like, can I do whatever I want there? Is it arbitrary? Can I just be like at foo? Oh my god. It feels like it's. Bun I. God, I have to keep doing this. Bun I. Winnie and Baxter. You guys are annoying. Baxter, I'm gonna send you to Ohio if you don't stop. All right, we're gonna ask Claude. See if Claude can figure this shit out. When using Vercel's Turbo Repo, how is the I don't even know what the at repo slash package at repo prefix set slash defined. I don't think that's true, is it? I'm so stupid. It's literally just the name of the package JSON of the child stuff. It's literally the opposite of dark magic. It's the normal way to do things. God damn it. Okay. Brilliant, chat. Brilliant. All right, so now let's see if we can swap out. We want to get rid of this. We want to get rid of... we want to keep the scripts, but we can get rid of these scripts and that script. And in here, we want to get rid of, we don't need you anymore. We want to come into lib. Let's start at the package JSON, huh? And in the turbo repo example, if we go to, I don't know, let's go here, apps. Oh, thank you for the raid. Welcome, raiders. How is your stream? At, how did I say your name? Ameques? We are working on setting up a small mono repo using Turbo. I'm starting to have multiple apps running for this client project, and I want to be able to share some TypeScript packages across them. What were you working on? So we just say that. Okay. So we should be able to return or replace Drizzle with this should be able to become at R10 slash what did we say, DB? And was it a star, I think? And we should be able to delete our drizzle kit. You probably still need the PG types. We're working on a Unity game? Nice. Ame. Okay. I will note that. Well, thank you for the raid, Ame. I appreciate that. Just gave you a follow. So we were working on a client project that I was hired for. Essentially, it is the client is a financial advisor who runs a coaching practice. And it's essentially upfront a tool to manage his coaching practice, but it's eventually going to be multi-tenant and he's going to sell the program to other financial advisor coaches. It's kind of a unique situation because this is a person I have a lot of trust with and have known for a long time. So the way the contract's set up is basically that there's a revenue share on the back end. There's no really tight deadlines at the moment, and I have freedom to stream it and use whatever tech I want. So it's a pretty fun thing going on. Thank you so much. Right now we're working on going from like a kind of large unorganized repo to using some mono repo tooling, and then we're going to jump back into our job queue where we're going to be processing Excel files that are uploaded through the SvelteKit app. They get dumped into blob storage, and then we have a job processor service that's running and looks at Postgres. I have a job queue table and we use PG notify. And that picks up jobs, processes on them. So for this example, it's going to pick up a process file upload job. It'll go to blob storage, read that Excel file into memory, and then we're going to parse that Excel file into other database tables. That way we're not like blocking up a ton of work in the SvelteKit event loop. So hopefully this repo setup shouldn't take too much longer here, and we'll get into actual
functions
real code.
Describe the world.
So we should be able to get rid of that.
Functions,
and we probably want the rest of that.
The world.
We can get rid of these.
Functions.
Thank you for the follows,
the
y'all.
World.
Super appreciate you. Okay, so we're gonna have type errors now, assuming I have this set up right. Let's go to our lib server and go into Drizzle. And the first thing we're gonna run into here is, I would expect once we run bun install in apps/front, all right, I didn't set that up correctly. Why? And you fall. All right, so this is the packet, right? That was the package we were just looking at, web apps. Let's load the package up for UI over here. So this should be repo. And let's go there. Packages, UI, and let's look at the package. Private version 000. All right, so let's do that in ours. I want to get the same views up basically. So let's go look at our package on the left, which is our DB package. We probably want a version, and we're going to keep that 0.0.0. All right, that's what we did over here. And we probably want U. We probably want X. I don't know if we're going to want to do exports or not. There's no module setup. So let's go ahead and add private true, get rid of that. Let's add the exports. So let's come in here, let's say exports, and we're going to export source drizzle. Can I do globs in this? Do we think? That feels fine, right? How do Excel files enter the system? So there's a SvelteKit front end to this where the clients who are being coached, they will get, they will upload monthly metrics. Right now they all work for the same, right now all of this advisor's clients all work for the same firm or mutual company. It's one of the big mutual companies. And they get generated reports every month. And they'll take those generated reports with all their stats and metrics, and they'll upload it to my client system or this app system through just like a file upload in the SvelteKit app. When that Excel file gets uploaded, what happens behind the scene is it hits a SvelteKit server endpoint, and that goes and stores it in Supabase blob storage. and it also publishes a job to our job queue table in Postgres. We have another process running on its own server, which is a job queue, and it's hooked up with PG Notify watching that job queue table. So that service will see that a new job has entered the job queue. It'll pick it up, and that has information about like the ID and the file path in blob storage, and it'll go out, fetch it, and then read it into memory. And then we process it and basically break it out of this Excel spreadsheet and go save it in database tables out of band. All right, let's make sure there's nothing else we need over here. Because it looks like we did everything the same. This seems fine. No, not right now, no. We probably will eventually push like an in-app notification to the advisor or to the coach when his clients upload metrics, but at the moment, no. I feel like it starts to become worth it once you have multiple processes running and want to share packages across them, which is exactly the point I'm at right now. I don't know what that keybind is. I hate when I do that. All right, so over here, that seems like everything. We have this. All right, so let's go look at our root. Package. That seems right. Private true. Those all seem correct. We're going to change prettier out for biome in a moment. All right, so that seems good on the root and the package. So let's go back to, here's our package at r10/db. And then this will be our app. Private true. All right, let's look at the app one. Private true. I don't think there's anything special in here. Unless they do something in the TypeScript. It's super possible they're doing something in the TypeScript config. So let's go check that real quick. Packages, TypeScript config, base. All right, nothing crazy there. Nothing crazy there. Nothing crazy there. Okay, it does nothing for imports. So it seems like we're set up identical. And we should be able to do at r10db star, right? That's what they do, star. Yeah, that's exactly what they do. So let's go to the root of the repo and try to install. Why? Fun I. Ah. Yeah, we can actually get rid of that now. We don't need that in our apps. This old job processor, this was a Rust app. Right? Yeah. So let's, we have that in Git history, so we don't need that anymore. Yeah, I know it's not empty. All right, if you're gonna make me do it this way. Okay. Great, that seems to have worked. Bun PM, trust all. Using Helix full time, everything is slow. As in your productivity is slow. All right, so this looks like it's working. I think we got it set up right. All right, I think we're good. So let's come back into our apps now. Or let's actually quit and I don't know, right quit all. Git status. Yeah, we'll just do that. And we'll go in here, Vim. Oops. Oh. New Vim, baby. It's all you need. All right, into apps, and let's start with front. And in front, we want to go to source, lib, server. Let's just say this is gonna be database. Well, we can change that later, but in here, this should now not come from Drizzle. Delete that. And we want to get import, let's just say foo from at r10/db/drizzle/ Maybe we don't want the exports in the package. Can I put a star in there like that? Is it a glob? Cannot find. Or it's corresponding, maybe we don't even need exports, and we'll do bun I. Now we should have source drizzle/db. Star as foo. foo.db, yeah. So we should be able to do export db from at r10/db/drizzle. I really think I should be able to do, let's go look up the docs for npm or package JSON exports. It really feels like I how am I not getting npm as the top result? This is annoying. I want to just program exports. Does it support globs? No, I want exports. Star. Okay, so I should be able to do /star.ts as /star.ts. Right? That seems like it should work. And then over here, we should have /drizzle. Cannot find module. Oh, we forgot DB. LOL. Why? It looks like that should work, right, chat? Like, I'm not crazy. One of these did this. Why? I hate JavaScript tooling with an undying passion. All right, let's see if we can even just directly export a single file, drizzle/db, and this is going to be changing this ./source/drizzle/db.ts, and let's see if we can just come down here, bun install, and now in here I should be able to /db.ts. Why star.ts/? Feels like this should work based on the docs. Okay, that works. I don't want the... So dumb. This is so stupid. Wait, now this is working? What? Did we not do this already? Okay. We don't need the schema anymore, so we can delete this. Queries. This seems fine. And this is going to come from in fact, we don't even really need that DB file, except POV, JavaScript, dude, so true. It's so stupid. Okay, so we want to do at R10 slash DB slash drizzle slash schema. Okay, I don't know why this is having type errors. Probably because we uninstalled drizzle ORM. We should really just move these queries over to this package. No, we shouldn't. They're pretty specific to this app. So let's go back in here and get the package JSON for our front. So let's actually do front slash package and add reinstall apps slash front. And we'll do bun I drizzle form. Why? We must have uninstalled a dependency. Possibly. Let's close this window. We want to go to front slash package JSON. Yoink you, types PG is still in here. Okay. We still have Postgres. Why? Por qué? Porque Maria. I don't know if this is a good layout, but can you have the queries in the DB package then have files on front end calls that? We could, but like the queries are pretty app specific. No, we don't want to be in here. I think I might, that's probably part of the problem, is that we fucked up the path. Durandalal, yeah. Bun, I, sure, that's fine. Project bucket list. Change into apps slash front, PN, not PN, bun, I, yeah, we'll do that for us. Okay, let's see if this helps at all. Apps, front, source, lib, server, drizzle, db. This is still resolving. Okay, great. And are our queries good in here? They're fine in here. Okay. And this is all fine. So if we go to front slash drizzle and then go up into queries, how are you getting this confused? Let's see if we can just even write a basic select. Right, so let's copy this example, yoink. Yeah, you're fine. You're gonna be fine. Okay. That seems fine. It seems like these things are the things that are messed up. It's like as soon as I try to use like dot where. And what did this look like before? Where? Let's just grab this inner one. All right. What are we upset about? Argument type SQL unknown or type import. I wonder if they have different versions. Let's make sure our versions are equal because that's a possible issue that we need to rule out. This is so dumb. I don't want to be doing this at all. This is not what I wanted to do this morning. I thought this would be fast. Drizzle ORM. I know we're going to use, there's a tool called SyncPack. We actually use that in our repos at work. Form. All right, what version are we on? We're on 0.33.0. So let's go ahead. We're going to pin all of our versions to that. So in our package JSON here, we're going to where's drizzle ORM? We're literally just gonna pin it on that. God damn it, I think they probably do have the same thing. And let's grab the most recent Postgres. That's 3.4.4. We're just gonna pin that, and then the Postgres types at types PG. That's on 8.11.9. So let's pin that to that. And now we'll do the same things for our this will be db/package.json. Drizzle ORM is pinned to the wrong version. Look at that. You see that? That's probably the problem. Oh, Node.js, how I loathe thee. Postgres is on 3.4.4. 8.11.6 for the types. 8.11.9.
Functions describe the world.
All right. Let's just bun I force. Bun I force. And then finally into packages/db bun I dash force. Why did SvelteKit get installed there? All right. Let's just get out all this shit, go back in, make sure TS server is not confused. Apps, front, source, lib, server, drizzle, queries, don't be a dick. Why? All right, time to bring in AI. Help me debug this. Yeah, that's what I've... can I do that with bun? All right, what was the first hand? Maybe we can get away. Bun update drizzle ORM installed, sure. Yes, it does. Bun, yeah. Okay, they're both right. Bun, PM, cache, remove. Bun, PM, cache, remove. Sudo remove dash RF. We're getting this. I don't even care. This is now personal. type checking if you're using, make sure TS kind of. Maybe it is our TS config. All right. I'm going to basically time box this for another 15 minutes. And if we don't get through it, we're going to pivot and work on some never throw open source for the last hour. Because I thought this was only going to take like 15 minutes and now I want to eat a gun. Yep, I ate my words. All right. Let me do a tree. Damn it, bad cop. Here is my file system, project layout. And then so here's my package JSON, root package JSON. Yeah, I guess we can do that, right? We'll just do that. Change directory into packages, that. And then Z front. All right, I want to show, let's go grab the TS config of DB package, put that in, and then we'll say package JSON of app/front, not package, that should be TS config. So let's go grab that. And finally, and the svelte kit ts config in front. Help me, Claude. I think it's hallucinating this. I'm almost positive it's probably going to hallucinate that. Yeah. I don't think. That was not helpful at all. Okay, so that was stupid. So we're gonna do this the easy way. Bunx bun install dash d sync pack. And like it should be good at doing JS because it has the most training on it. Like, all right, how do I init? Can I do an init? Yeah, let's just go to here, get started, list, install, exec, sync pack list.
Functions describe the world.
All right, so let's just do a bunx sync pack list. It seems like everything's on the same dependencies. Right? Hold on, let me go to the root. Possible issues. Possible problem with TypeScript too. Oh, I bet it is TypeScript. I upgraded one of the package to 5.6.2 instead of 5. Look at this. Okay, I bet it's TypeScript because a bunch changed in 5.6.2. Sync pack just saved my life. Yeah, blah, blah, blah. Create the following. So let's go in here. Syncpack is a great tool for mono repos. It helps make sure all your packages use the same dependencies. Let's do that. Go in here. Yoink you. Copy that. We're going to put that in, and we're actually going to go and just do everything at once. Put that in. Is that how that works? No, that's not how that works. Okay. Sync pack list. Yeah, I think they did add something. I'm using bun here though, and I don't know if bun has that built in. Okay. Semver groups. Suppose you. No, I don't care about that. Here we go. List mismatches. So I want to get everything on TypeScript 5.6.2. What is, can I set from the command line format update to choose updates from the npm registry? I forget the JSON. Config. I want to just set a specific package. All right, maybe we can use that funx sync pack. Instead of that, we'll do prompt. I guess, okay, let's try fix mismatches. YOLO, here we go. Right, so. All right, hold on. Check. I want to check one thing real quick. Hell, who's messaging me right now? Bodhi. Guys, stop it. Actually, chat, I gotta bounce. There's an incident at work I gotta take care of. I'm sorry. Annoying, but we'll be back tomorrow. Sorry, I gotta run. Who can we go raid? Toggle bit. Yes, I know, guys. All right, peace, chat. Sorry about the ending early. I just got to help take care of something. Bye.